Welcome to this segment of the Chemistry of Beer. The topic of this segment is anaerobic metabolism. To begin our discussion of anaerobic metabolism, we will first of all think about the big picture. Why must the cell not stop at pyruvate? This will require that we revisit glycolysis. Next, we'll discuss the different fates of pyruvate when anaerobic conditions prevail. And then finally, we'll wrap up some loose ends and summarize our discussion. To begin our discussion of anaerobic metabolism, we first of all need to revisit glycolysis. The step I wanted to emphasize was the step where NADH is formed. This is the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase reaction. We see that glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Concurrent with that, NAD+ is reduced to NADH. Remember, this happens twice because we effectively have two glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates that are converted to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. So one of our products of glycolysis is two NADH molecules. So I said earlier that the cell cannot stop at pyruvate. It has to do something with that pyruvate. When aerobic conditions are prevailing, we've seen that the pyruvate can enter the mitochondria and be oxidatively decarboxylated to acetyl-CoA and then enter the tricarboxylic acid cycle, or the TCA cycle. But what happens when oxygen is limiting or oxygen is not in great supply? How does the cell then function? If we look at our diagram and we focus on pyruvate, the top part of our diagram, and we move to the left, that would be what happens when oxygen is present. This can apply to both humans and yeast. When oxygen is present, the pyruvate undergoes the reactions of the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, where it is converted to acetyl-CoA, which can then enter the citric acid cycle. The reduced cofactors, FADH2 and NADH, can then enter the electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation, and we make a lot more ATP. As I mentioned earlier, oxidative phosphorylation is much more efficient. But what happens when oxygen is not present or not sufficient? In humans, the pyruvate will then undergo a reaction that's catalyzed by the enzyme lactate dehydrogenase. This enzyme converts pyruvate into lactate. Specifically, pyruvate is reduced to lactate. Therefore, something else has to be oxidized. That something else is NADH. NADH is oxidized back to NAD+. This is important because unless this happens, glycolysis cannot continue. There are limited pools of NADH and NAD+, and remember, glycolysis forms NADH. If we don't somehow recycle and get back to NAD+, the cell can no longer run glycolysis. So that is why in humans, we have to do something with the pyruvate, and that something we do is catalyzed by lactate dehydrogenase so that the pyruvate becomes lactate and we regenerate NAD+. In yeast, they have an enzyme, which we don't have, called pyruvate decarboxylase. As the name implies, this enzyme catalyzes the decarboxylation of pyruvate to make acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde, as you'll recall, is that toxic molecule, and so the yeast don't want the acetaldehyde levels to build up, so the next reaction that is catalyzed by our old friend ADH, alcohol dehydrogenase. This is the reverse of the reaction that we learned when we discussed alcohol metabolism. Now, the acetaldehyde is being reduced to ethanol. This allows the NADH to be reoxidized to NAD+, and that's what the yeast needs in order to continue running glycolysis. It needs to regenerate NAD+. So that is the secret to how yeast make ethanol. We grow them in conditions where we deprive them of oxygen, and that forces them to go anaerobic. They take the pyruvate, which is the end product of glycolysis, and they decarboxylate it to acetaldehyde, which they then reduce to ethanol, concurrent with the oxidation of NADH to NAD+. Now that they've regenerated the NAD+, they can continue running glycolysis. So now we are ready to wrap up our discussion of anaerobic metabolism. If the cell, yeast or human, is functioning aerobically with oxygen, then the pyruvate can be further metabolized to carbon dioxide and water via the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, the tricarboxylic acid cycle, and the electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation. This process yields significantly more ATP than does the anaerobic process. If the cell, yeast or human, is functioning anaerobically, then the pyruvate has to be reduced to lactate, which happens in humans, or decarboxylated to acetaldehyde, and then reduced to ethanol, which happens in yeast. Both of these pathways regenerate NAD+, which is needed to continue running glycolysis.